Something very weird and confusing happened this week. And that weird and confusing thing that, by the way, is not just confusing me, it's actually confusing investors and financial experts. But the weird thing is that the stock price of the Trump Media and Technology Group, the company that owns Truth Social, shot back up this week, back to the level that they were at when the stock was first introduced. And of course, that was the time when Trump shares became worth $6 billion. Then it lost so much value that his shares were down to under $3 billion. Now it's all the way back up. And what's weird about that is that nothing has changed with the financial stability of this company. They still lost more than $50 million last year on a revenue of $4 million. They haven't fixed anything with the platform. They haven't attracted any major new advertisers. So why is the stock price going up? That's actually the question, by the way, that financial experts and even people who own Truth Social stock want to know. They're very confused. Let me read you this. This is an investor and attorney by the name of Michael Melkerson claimed that he's sitting on hundreds of thousands of shares of Trump Media, and he said it's paid off for him, but out of an abundance of caution, he's still looking to sell it. He says, quote, "I believed in it, but I am too heavily invested for my own comfort." So this guy's like, yeah, it's doing well, but I got to get out of here because this isn't normal. Then you have Justin Yoakum, who's a co-owner of Selway, an Idaho-based investment advisory firm. He explained that his firm purchased Trump Media and Technology Group warrants, which provide his investor clients the right to a new stock at a fixed price as long as regulators approve the new shares. And he said, "I believe the company itself is worth zero." Okay, so you own an investment firm and you've got a ton of shares in the company. And even you're admitting, like, this company is worthless. I mean, I bought the stock. I know it's worthless, but why not, right? But that actually gives us a better clue as to why some people, some of these investment firms, not just your average everyday Trump supporters buying the stock, this explains why they're doing it, right? They're expecting more shares to come into the market, which they can buy at a fixed price. Once those shares come in, it's probably going to cause a slight dip in the market or in the market share of this company, which will cause a bunch of people to buy up those new stocks, the mom and pop people, the true MAGA freaks, and that's going to make the price go way up. At that point, all of these groups that have, you know, hundreds of thousands of shares, they sell, make a massive profit off the top, but because they've sold so much, the price is going to bottom out again. So that could help explain why the price is kind of being driven up right now. It's almost being driven up artificially by these groups coming in and snatching up as much as they can because they're expecting, because Trump and his company have asked for this, more stock to be released. And that's going to cause this, you know, weird up and down roller coaster. But they're planning on getting off the roller coaster at the top while all of those other, you know, just regular MAGA buyers are going to ride it all the way back down. So don't be fooled. Even the people buying the stock are admitting that the company is worthless. They're just betting that they can make a quick profit and get out of there before it bottoms out again. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.